I'm going to look at a riff today that Stevie learned from Albert King, and I'm not sure if Albert King was the first person to play this, but he certainly is the one who kind of put this riff on the map, just the style that he played it in. It's a riff that's been used by just about every blues player since then, but it sounds a little bit like this. Now, you can hear this in Texas Flood, just about any slow blues song that Stevie played. And if you go back to Albert King, you'll hear him playing this all the time. There's a million different ways that you can play it to add a little bit of flavor to it. But we're just going to look at the real basic version today. And it goes like this. Now, I'm playing in the key of G flat here, which is the key that Stevie played Texas Flood in. My guitar is tuned down half step, so those of you playing in standard tuning are going to be playing, I'm not sure what key that would be, but anyway. The standard blues box for this key is just simply right here. So there's our root. The riff starts up here, which is just the root note on the second string, and we're going to play in this little box right here. But instead of actually going all the way up here, we're just going to bend this note up. Alright, so, you want to get your hands like this. You want to start on the root here, and you can put a little vibrato on that note, and you're just going to go. So we're going to skip right from this, two hits on that, and then right up to the bend. So, as you see, I played actually two different varieties of it there, but the one that we want to focus on today is the one where we bend first. So the rhythm is. So I'm going to play it real slow here. Of course, I'm going to put some vibrato on it at the end. One thing that you can do to give this riff a little extra snap is to actually, instead of picking this bend, you can actually pluck this string using your. Any of the fingers that you're not using to hold the pick, so you can have this sound. Sounds a little bit different than, so you get a little bit extra snap. All right, so once again, to wrap up, we're just gonna start on the root. And in future lessons, I'm gonna look at ways that you can extend that into other riffs. Oh, yeah.